This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Treaty of Brest-Litovsk was a peace treaty signed on March 3, 1918 between the Russian SFSR and the Central Powers, but prior to that on February 9, 1918, the Central Powers signed an exclusive protectorate treaty German, Bratfrieden, Peace for Bread, with the Ukrainian People's Republic as part of the negotiations that took place in Brest-Litovsk, Grodno Governorate now Brest, Belarus recognizing the sovereignty of the Ukrainian Republic although not formally annexing the territory of the former Russian Empire, Germany and Austria-Hungary secured food supply support in return for providing military protection. The Quadruple Alliance recognized Ukraine as a neutral state. Contents 1 Intentions 2 The Peace Negotiations 21 Signatories 3 Terms of the Peace Treaty 4 Effects of the Treaty 5 Notes 6 Further Reading 7 External Links Intentions Ukrainian People's Republic because of the civil unrest in the Russian Republic culminating in the October Revolution. The Ukrainian People's Republic declared its independence under the government of the General Secretariat of Ukraine. In its declaration, the General Secretariat announced elections for the Ukrainian Constituent Assembly to be held on January 9, 1918 and the first convocation on January 22 of the same year. On December 17, 1917, Vladimir Lenin as the head of the Sovnarkom released an ultimatum in which he accused the Central Rada of disorganizing the front lines, stopping any troops going into the region of the Don, the Urals, or elsewhere, sheltering political enemies such as the members of the Cadet Party and ones who sided with Kaledin, as well as a requirement to put an end to the attempts to crush the armies of the Soviet and of the Red Guard in Ukraine. Lenin gave 24 hours' notice to the government of what he called the Independent and Bourgeois Republic of the Ukraine to respond, having Soviet armies already in Ukraine. The government of Ukraine had to act quickly to preserve the sovereignty of the state. The Ukrainian Central Rada expressed a desire for a peace treaty with foreign countries and its recognition worldwide, since the representatives of the British and French empires did not wish to recognize its sovereignty, considering it as a part of their major ally, the Russian Empire. The treaty would give a chance for some recognition in face of the Central Powers. On January 1, 1918, a Ukrainian delegation headed by Sevalid Holubovich arrived at Brest-Litovsk. The initial delegation, beside Mykola Lyubinsky, Alexander Sevrik, and Mykola Levitsky, included Mykhailo Poloz. The peace negotiations see also Kiev Arsenal, January Uprising, and Ukrainian-Soviet War. The peace negotiation was initiated by the government of Soviet Russia on December 3, 1917, represented by the delegation headed by the Ukrainian-born Leon Trotsky. Several resolutions were reached between December 22-26, and on December 28, 1917 an armistice was signed suspending hostilities at front lines. Prior to that, a Soviet government of Ukrainian Socialist Soviet Republic was formed in Kharkiv on December 17, 1917. The final undersigning was being procrastinated by Bolsheviks in hope of reaching some agreement with the Entente Treaty members on January 12, 1918. Count Ottokar Chernin, as a representative of the Central Powers, recognized the independent delegation from the Ukrainian People's Republic, but together with Sysaki refused to discuss the questions of Halychina, Bukovina, and Subcarpathian Rus. They agreed that the Komi Governorate and the region of Podlachia were part of the Ukrainian People's Republic. The Russian Bolshevik delegation, headed by Leon Trotsky, had at first also recognized the independent Ukrainian delegation on January 10. Delegates from the Ukrainian People's Republic and the Central Powers during a break in the negotiations in Brest-Litovsk. Early February 1918, the Ukrainian delegation returned on January 20, 1918 to Kiev, where the Central Narada proclaimed a fully sovereign Ukrainian state on January 25, dated January 22. Right after this, a new Ukrainian delegation was sent to Brest, headed now by Alexander Sevrik. Meanwhile, Bolshevik revolts occurred in different cities in Ukraine, which more or less forced the Ukrainian People's Republic, which was lacking organized military forces, to seek foreign aid. However, the situation for the Central Powers was also critical, especially for Austria-Hungary, which suffered severe food shortages. On February 1, a plenary session of the Congress was attended also by the Soviet government of Ukraine in the presence of Yukim Medvedev and Vasil Shakrai. Nevertheless, the Central Powers continued to negotiate with the delegation from the Ukrainian People's Republic as the sole representatives of Ukraine, while the Central Narada was abandoning Kiev for Bolshevik troops, a peace treaty was signed in Brest-Litovsk during the night of February 8-9 over the Bolsheviks' protests. The German newspaper Lübeck Ads on its front page Extrablatt printed the announcement about peace with the Ukraine. Today on February 9, 1918 at 2 o'clock in the morning, the peace between the Quadruple Alliance and the Ukrainian People's Republic was signed. Hude M. 9 February 1918, 2 Uhr morgens wurde der Fried zwischen dem Verbund und der Ukrainischen Volksrepublik unterzeichnet. Signatories Ukraine, German Empire, Austria, Hungary, Bulgaria, Ottoman Empire. Head of Delegation Severick, Foreign State Secretary von Kuhlmann, Foreign Minister Chernin, Prime Minister Radoslavov, Grand Vizier Mehmed Talat, Foreign Minister Lyubinsky, Ober Ost Hoffman, Ambassador Tashev I, Haki Pasha Levitsky I, Stoyanovich Onesimi Bey, Economical Advisor Ostapenko T, Anastasov P, Ganchev Ahmed Izzet Pasha. Within days of the treaty's signing, an army of over 450,000 men from the Central Powers entered Ukraine, and after only a month most of the Bolshevik troops had left the country without any significant resistance. Soon after the takeover of Kiev by Ukrainian and German troops, the Central Narada could return to Kiev on March 2. Terms of the peace treaty closing session of the peace protocol signing during the night between February 9 and 10, 1918 from the left, General Brinkman, Mykola Lyubinsky, Mykola Levitsky, Alexander Severick, General Max Hoffman and Serhii Ostapenko. Peace with the Ukraine. Freed MIT der Ukraine by Lübeck Ads February 9, 1918. The treaty recognized the following as the Ukrainian People's Republic's boundaries: in the west the 1914 Austro-Hungarian-Russian boundary, which excluded the Ukrainian Halychina in the new Ukrainian state; in the north the line running from Tarnograd, Bilgoraj, Shebezheshin, Krasnostaw, Radzin Podlaski and Miedzierzek Podlaski in present Lublin Voivodeship Poland, Sarnaki in present Masovian Voivodeship Poland, Kamianyez and Pruzhany in present Brest Voblast Belarus. The exact boundaries were to be determined by a mixed commission on the basis of ethnic composition and the will of the inhabitants. Article 2. The articles in the treaty also provided for the regulated evacuation of the occupied regions. Article 3. The establishment of diplomatic relations. Article 4. Mutual renunciation of war reparations. Article 5, the return of prisoners of war. Article 6, and the exchange of interned civilians and the renewal of public and private legal relations. Article 8. Article 7 provided for the immediate resumption of economic relations and trade and set down the principles of accounting and tariffs. Austria-Hungary and the Ukrainian People's Republic also signed a secret agreement regarding Halychina and Bukovina. Austria-Hungary agreed to unify by July 31, 1918 in one Crownland those areas of eastern Halychina and Bukovina where the Ukrainian population predominated, but on July 4, Austria-Hungary annulled this secret agreement under the pretext that Ukraine had not delivered to it the amount of grain promised under the treaty. It is believed that this action was the result of Polish pressure. The Central Powers signed a separate treaty of Brest-Litovsk with Bolshevist Russia on March 3, 1918. Russia agreed to recognize the concluded treaty with the Ukrainian People's Republic and to immediately sign a peace treaty with Ukraine, to define the borders between Russia and Ukraine without delay, to clear the Ukrainian territory of Russian troops and the Russian Red Guard, as well as put an end to all agitation or propaganda against the government or the public institutions of the Ukrainian People's Republic. Article 6. Effects of the treaty. Austro-Hungarian troops enter Kamianets Podilsky after the treaty had been signed in Brest-Litovsk. Austria-Hungary War Press Bureau. The treaty immediately caused much opposition among Poles, particularly those in Austria-Hungary. Polish politicians in the Austrian parliament immediately began their protests, paralyzing the parliament. Civil servants began a strike, and spontaneous demonstrations took place in various cities and towns. Most notably, the Polish Auxiliary Corps refused to follow Austrian orders, and after the Battle of Rarancha broke through the front lines to join Polish forces in the Russian Civil War. Although the Austrian government in Vienna withdrew from parts of the treaty, the damage it had caused to Polish-Austrian relations was significant, and the pro-Austrian and anti-independence faction of Polish-Austrian politicians was permanently weakened. The Treaty of Brest-Litovsk provided the Ukrainian People's Republic with German and Austro-Hungarian military aid in clearing Bolshevik forces from Ukraine in February to April 1918, but the treaty also meant that the Entente powers suspended relations with the Ukrainian People's Republic public soon. However, the invited foreign forces from the Central Powers were seen as occupants by a major part of the Ukrainian population and also parts of the Central Narada. In late April, the German Supreme Commander in Ukraine, Hermann von Eichhorn, issued an order making Ukrainians subject to German military courts for offenses against German interests. The first Ukrainian division, the Bluecoats, was disarmed, and German soldiers even arrested two ministers after they criticized the German actions. The final break with the Central Narada came on April 29, when General Pavlo Skoropadsky declared himself Hetman of the Ukrainian state. The Treaty of Rapallo of 1922 between Germany and Soviet Russia cancelled the German commitments made at Brest-Litovsk. The disintegration of Austria-Hungary in late 1918 automatically annulled its commitments. Turkey renounced the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk by signing a treaty with the Ukrainian SSR in 1922. Only Bulgaria, as far as is known, did not formally annul the treaty. Notes Carat Russian whom belong Brest in 1918. Argument among Ukraine, Belarus, and Germany. Ukraininska Pravda, March 25, 2011. Carat ABCDEF Encyclopedia of Ukraine. Carat AB Volodymyr Kubajovic ed. Ukraine, a concise encyclopedia. I. p. 744. Carat Orest Subtelny, Ukraine, a history. P. 352-353. Carat AB The Peace Treaty of Brest-Litovsk February 9, 1918. Carat The Peace Treaty of Brest-Litovsk March 3, 1918. Carat Polish Peter Galik, Kwalebna Zdrada, Raranca 1918. Carat Volodymyr Kubajovic ed. Ukraine, a concise encyclopedia. I. p. 745. Further reading Volodymyr Kubajovic ed. Ukraine, a concise encyclopedia. I. University of Toronto Press 1963. Orest Subtelny, Ukraine, a history. ISBN 0-8020-7191-0. U.S. Department of State Proceedings of the Brest-Litovsk Peace Conference, the peace negotiations between Russia and the Central Powers, the 21st of November 1917 to the 3rd of March 1918. Government Printing Office, Washington, 1918. External links. Encyclopedia of Ukraine. The Peace Treaty of Brest-Litovsk February 9, 1918. The Peace Treaty of Brest-Litovsk March 3, 1918. Digital copy of the U.S. Department of State book about the proceedings of the treaty. V.E. World War I Treaties During the War. Sykes Pickett Street Jean de Maurienne French Armenian Damascus Protocol London Brest Litovsk Ukraine Batum Paris Peace Conference Versailles Saint-Germain and Les Neuilly-sur-Seine Trianon Sèvres Aftermath. Rapallo 1920 Tartu 1920 Warsaw Riga 1920 Sawaki Alexandropol Moscow Riga 1921 Tartu 1921 Cilicia Ankara Kars Lausanne Rapallo 1922 Territories of the former Austro-Hungarian Monarchy Italian Reparation Payments Sino-German Peace Treaty Montreux Regime of the Turkish Straits Abolition of the Capitulations in Egypt British Egypt Denmark Greece Norway Sweden Portugal See also, 14 points Partitioning of the Ottoman Empire v.e. Modern Ukraine after the Russian Revolution 1917-1920 Universal Central Council of Ukraine Treaty of Brest-Litovsk Act Zaluki Ukrainian National States Ukrainian People's Republic Ukrainian State Ukrainian People's Republic led by Directorate Crimean National States Crimean People's Republic Crimean Regional Government Soviet States Ukrainian People's Republic of Soviets Ukrainian Soviet Republic Ukrainian Soviet Socialist Republic Taurida Soviet Socialist Republic Odessa Soviet Republic Donetsk Krivoy Raj Soviet Republic Parliament Central Council of Ukraine Minor Council Directorate Constituent Assembly Central Executive Committee of Ukraine Political parties Ukrainian Socialist Parties USDLP Independent Left Socialists Sovereigns UPSF Bolsheviks UPSR Boratbists Ukrainian Social Democratic Party Ukrainian Radical Party Communist Party of Western Ukraine Soviet of Peasants Deputies Ukrainian Peasant Society Soviet of Workers Deputies Soviet of Soldiers Deputies Jewish Socialist Parties Fereniakta The Bund Pole Zion Polish Socialist Parties Polish Democratic Center Party Polish Socialist Party Russian Socialist Parties Socialist Revolutionary Party Mensheviks Cadets Ukrainian National Democratic Alliance Major Figures Mykhailo Ryshevsky Volodymyr Vinichenko Sevalid Holobovich Simon Petliura Noman Selebichahan Yukim Medvedev Volodymyr Zatinsky Jorge Pyatakov Yuri Gavin Bela Kun All Ukrainian National Congress Congress of Peoples of Russia All Ukrainian Congress of Soviets Labor Congress of Ukraine